I'm for big juice. Will it be good? In our upcoming 320 expansion, Arch Nemesis will be replaced with a system that is. I told you it was gonna happen, dude. With a system that is more similar to the way monster mods worked in the past. I told you, dude. I told you it was gonna happen. I told you the Bex post really made it seem like they're gonna do this. I called it. When she posted that tweet, I called it. The issues that players often have with Arch Nemesis were the keyworded mod names are not fully descriptive of what they did. No, that's stupid. Only dumbasses can figure it out. The mods often add multiple effects bundled, which made them hard to understand. All right, that's fair. Do you know how many effects were included in a single mod? It made too many encounters too complex. The way Arch Nemesis rewards are meant to set up, players felt like they couldn't just kill a monster. They had to consider them being an MF character maximized rewards. Goals with new system are mods do one specific thing. Mods say that they're do what they do rather than having a thematic name you must learn to remember. Encounters are simplified on average while retaining interesting fights. Players are no longer required to do annoying actions to maximize rewards. No loot goblins. Yes. Mods do one specific thing. Here's an example. The Magma Barrier mod did a whole lot of stuff. It started by putting out a magma barrier around the character, but it didn't stop there because some of the monsters fizzed to fire. It added some extra fire damage on top. It granted fire resistance to the monster, and it gave some physical damage reduction for good measure. It also spawned volatile flame buds to follow you. The new equipment modifier just puts a magma barrier around the monster and nothing else. Thank God, dude. Thank fucking God. Mods say what they do rather than have a thematic name you must learn to remember. For example, rather than incendiary, which broke down six properties, you now see monsters either ignites or fire and ignite resistance. Instead of Deadeye, which did five different things, you see now applies random mark, extra crits, or accurate as summary unrelated mods. Encounters are simplified on average while retaining interesting fights. The pool of mods that involve complex interaction, like spawning volatiles or ground effects on death, have been heavily diluted by the presence of simpler mods. This means that you encounter more complex fights less frequently, but interesting and challenging emergent behavior from overlapping mods can still happen, just less often. Players are no longer required to do annoying actions to maximize rewards. In Arch Nemesis, rewards were associated with individual mods. That meant you could tell what kind of mods you'd get in advance. In some cases, you are then effectively required to fetch an MF calling character to make sure that you maximize the value of the monster mod you had found. In other cases, you would ignore a monster completely if you knew that it would only drop rewards that were no value to you. In the new system, we had added a significant pool of new rewards to rares, but the reward that is on the monster is hidden, not associated with specific mods. You don't know what kind of rewards you'll get until you kill a monster. Rare monsters with more mods are more likely to have these special hidden reward mods. This new reward system smooths out the spikiness that the Arch Nemesis reward system have. I wonder if MF will be, or I wonder if like full juicing MF will be fixed from this. Conclusion: the original motivation for developing Arch Nemesis was that the previous monster mod system is very out of date. Many of the mods didn't have appreciable effect under modern bounds, and there wasn't a lot of interesting gameplay possible. In our opinion, Arch Nemesis did succeed at adding a lot of interesting new mechanics to rares, but introduced the problems described above while creating the new monster mods described in this article. We were careful to retain most of the interesting mechanics that Arch Nemesis introduced, but in a way that didn't include a grab bag of other effects and is diluted by other simpler mods. They did it, dude. The result is a system that is very similar to what monster mods used to be like, but with much more up-to-date content and balance. Mods are simpler and say exactly what they do, but you can still certainly encounter scary rare combos of mods that really wake you up. It's a lot rarer than it was under Arch Nemesis' system. We feel the new system is more modern and interesting than the old one. It is clearer and easier to understand the heat of combat than Arch Nemesis was. Log in, dude. Log in. I knew they weren't. When that Beck suite went out the other day, I was like, they're removing it. I told you. I called it. This is huge. This is huge. This guy. this right here is the problem with people. This guy didn't even read it and then posted. Is that you, Toivo? This is huge. I really hope it fixes like juicing though. I mean, I don't really care. It doesn't really affect me, but I think it should be in the game. Yeah, I mean, I'm curious what the drops are gonna be like now. By we, do you mean all 0.01% of the player base that does ultra juicing? Yeah, you guys probably do have issues.